So what happens when you have a custom directive, it's a component, say call it panel, and then you put something like a button inside of your custom component. We haven't defined it yet, but you know our button would look like that. But once we define our directive, if it's a directive that we give a template, so we'll call this panel, return, and restrict to an element, and then give it a template of, let's see, we'll just say div with the class of panel, and we'll say this is a panel component. It's a great component. All right, so if we refresh in here, you can see that it's rendered out our template. Yet our button that we defined in here is completely disappeared because the template has pretty much overridden it and destroyed the content that was in there. So if you want that content to be carried over from the DOM into your directive, what you need to do is set up something called transclusion. So it's a very funky name for actually a pretty simple concept. If you say transclude true, I like to say it's going to yank this and basically copy and paste it into wherever you define ng transclude. So if you say ng transclude on this element, it's going to append it into that div. So it's taking it from the inside of where we defined it, basically copied and pasted and dropped it into our component because we said transclude there and then added transclude to our element. So this is a pretty common scenario as far as making your HTML markup very descriptive and declarative of what's going on. You'll probably run into this scenario quite a bit, and it's really easy to use. There are some pretty advanced cases around transclusion, and that'll get into like the compiling phase and things like that, and we'll talk more about that as we get into more advanced stuff. But for right now, this is pretty simple, so go ahead and start using it.